Department of Transportation's Federal Motor Carrier Safety Administration issued a regional emergency declaration for 17 states and Washington, D.C. to keep fuel supply lines open. Corn, latest commodity to soar. Again, I've been warning you about inflation, potentially hyperinflation here in the United States and worldwide. Prices have risen roughly 50% in 2021, and a bushel costs more than twice what it did a year ago. This is according to the Wall Street Journal. So we have a massive inflationary event currently occurring. Corn, of course, goes into almost everything. Almost all food, all household products, even diapers. So expect the prices of goods and services to rise. Now, if the Federal Reserve has indicated that they think inflation is going to pick up a little bit to say 2 to 3%, times that by 10, or times that by 100, or times that by 1,000, because this is the only environment where we allegedly have stable inflation, but the prices of goods like used cars are up 40, 50%. Or housing costs are up 20, 30%. Or people can't find housing. Or they're getting booted out of their homes as a result of the moratoriums that will soon be going away. So whether or not it's corn rising 50% in 2021, a bushel costing more than twice what it did a year ago, or it's 2x4s up like 3-4 times the original value a year ago, or it's the cryptocurrency market, Ethereum breaking 4,000 for the first time ever, hitting a new all-time record high. We have gone up 4x from like 1,000, breaking 4,000 just over the last few months. That's why you should be learning about this stuff. Or it's the average cost of gasoline, or the average cost of bananas, milk, poultry, food, or meat. You should notice an ongoing trend here. So what I believe, and you should follow me on Twitter. We've actually gotten a lot of new subscribers. Thank you so much on Twitter. Follow me at AMT.
All right. Shalom. This is the brother Yawanathan, about out of Wong, coming at you with another lesson through the spirit and power of Yahweh Shemel Shah. Lord, when I pray that it's edifying. First and foremost, as always, I want to start off by giving all praises and glorifications to Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, Bahasham, Rakakwadash, the honors of the apostles and elders at Great Millstone and Well. Peace, love, and salutations to the hopeful elect throughout the four corners of the earth, preaching his word in truth and sincerity. All right. And a lot of these, what you just saw is Christopher Green. I don't know if a lot of brothers tune into him, but I tune into him because he brings out some information regarding like how the, you know, how the economy is doing, like as far as it's going down, because they see my economists. They know, man. They know that this place is done, man. Okay, and this was a spirit, because right when I was getting ready to do the video, I seen this notification of his video going live. All right, and I decided to play some of it. He said some very key things, man, because inflation, we're in an inflation period, man, but pretty soon it's going to turn into a hyperinflation period, man, which pretty much prices are going to go through the roof, man. Okay, prices are going to go through the roof. And what I've been harping on through the spirit is with the old pandemic thing, you know, they condition you people, you know, they got you, they pretty much getting you where they want you to be concerning this pandemic. Now, you know, with the whole cyber attack thing, they attacking pretty much more of the economy, you know. They're going to pretty much get ready to crash this dollar, man, fully, man, which they're going to work on crashing the economy, like I said. You know, hyperinflation is going to bring that, man, pretty much inflation, hyperinflation. Salakia, let me get off that. Let me see something. I want to look up that word hyperinflation. I'm going to go ahead and then I'm going to get some scriptures. I don't want to make this too long. I'm going to be out, you know. This talking about many great miseries, man. And this is definitely part of the great miseries. Okay. This is hyperinflation. The definition, it says hyperinflation is a term to describe rapid, excessive, and out of control general price increases in an economy, which we're currently, a lot of places, a lot of businesses are currently seeing now, man. All right. When prices are going up steadily. Like gas prices down here, like I mentioned, we had that cyber attack, ransomware, you know, which is, they expect
this to
have an effect on gas prices. Okay, and I was looking at CNN earlier this morning, and they say they might not be able to fix this thing to the end of the week. So pretty much these devils are working. They want to see how it affects, you know, the prices and how people will react, you know, because the scriptures say we're not ignorant of Satan's devices, man. Okay, so let me start from the top again on this definition of hyperinflation. It says hyperinflation is a term describe rapid, excessive, and out of control general price increases in the economy. Okay, while inflation is a measure of the pace, see that? This is talking about just regular inflation. While inflation is a measure of the pace of rising prices for goods and services, hyperinflation is rapidly rising inflation, typically measuring more than 50% per month. So hyperinflation is a bigger, you know, increase, a excessive amount of price rising, man, so to speak. You know, and that's what we're approaching, man, where you're going to have loaves of bread being damn $20. Gas real soon could go up to being $6, $7, $8, $9, $10, man. Okay, because they talking about this summer, that's going to be low gas, man. You know, a lot of you people that planning these summer vacations, a lot of you niggas that's planning these summer vacations, guess what? You're going to be disappointed, man, because y'all ain't going no goddamn where, especially when these gas prices rise more and more, man. It's locking. You niggas ain't going nowhere, man. Okay? Nowhere to see your cousins and aunties, uncles this summer, man, are going on summer vacations, man. You might as well kick. Hey, a lot of you might as well throw that out the window, man. Okay? Now, y'all thought 2020 was bad. Oh, man, y'all ain't seen nothing yet, man. 2021. All right? Hey, this could be the year, man. Lord willing, because this the Apostle Tahar deemed it. Okay? The year of hastening. The coming day of our Lord, Yahweh Bashimah Shah, man. Okay? So let me get in some scriptures, man. I'm going to be out, man. Okay? First scripture I want to start off with. Let me see. I got to go to the Apocrypha for this one. Many great miseries, man. Let's go to many great miseries. Second Ezra, I believe. 8 and 50. Through the spirit and power of Yahweh Shemel Shah, because that's what's coming, man. Okay, here it is. 2 Ezra 8 and 50 says, for many great miseries shall be done to them that in the latter time shall dwell in the world. In the latter time, what's that talking about? Latter times, talking about the end days, last days, which we're currently in right now. Pretty much when the last days of the last days, man. Okay, it says because they have walked in great pride. And I mentioned in camp yesterday, you got certain people that admit or say that we're in the last days, but you know, you don't act like it, man. You know, look how these people conducting themselves, man. They ain't acting like we're in the last days. They're not being prepared. They're just going about their business because so things are so-called opening back up, you know. Like it goes with that scripture, though they say peace and safety, then comes sudden destruction. And that's what's coming, man. That's what's coming. I can get that next, you know. So I'm going to start from the top again. It says, for many great miseries shall be done to them. And that's talking about you wicked-ass people, man. All right? Primarily you Israelites, because, hey, you the primary, you one of the main primary targets of the Most High's judgment, man. Two-thirds got to be punished, man. All right? It says, for many great miseries shall be done to them that in the latter time shall dwell in the world because they have walked in great pride. And the Most High hates pride, man. You know, the Most High hates pride. All right? And you people are going to be destroyed for your pride out here, man. Think everything, you think you in the clear because people taking the knockout punch, the juice, and things are seeming like it's getting back to normal. Mask restrictions are easing. Like the scripture says, they should think of themselves in good case, man. And you people are not in good case out here, man. You think you are, but you're not. Right? The nigga woman think it's all good. You know? Because she's still at ease. You niggas, man. All right, Esau thinking his society is going to prolong much longer. You know, you people got another thing coming, man. Okay, because Jacob's trouble concerning you tribes is on the horizon. Okay, and the Most High is going to make a lot of you people suffer, man. A lot of you people suffer. So let's get that scripture, man. Hey, a lot. This scripture been coming out a lot lately, man. I'm gonna get it, man. Hey, say, we brought it out at camp yesterday, and I was watching videos. A lot of brothers was going in this scripture, man. First Thessalonians chapter 5, man. Can't bring this out enough. Hey, this got to be brought out more than ever now. Or one of the scriptures got to be brought out more than ever. This is 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 1. It says, but of the times and the seasons, brethren, okay, ye have no need that I write unto you, for yourselves know perfectly that the day of the Lord so cometh as a thief in the night. And I was just harping on this too, man, how, you know, you people are not watching. You're never prepared. Until, the only way you're prepared is when it actually happens, man. You're not ready till the a certain drastic event actually happens, man. You know, something to that effect. I forgot exactly how I was thinking, you know, concerning basically I'm saying, like, you people, you know, you wait at the last minute, man. You know, you wait at the last minute. When it comes, then, hey, you're not prepared, man. So you're going to be caught out there. Okay, so that's why the Lord says he's coming as a thief in the night, man. Okay, and that's why that old saying, man, hey, stay ready so you don't have to get ready, man. Stay ready so you don't have to get ready. All right. So I'm going to read verse 2 again. It says, for yourselves know perfectly that the day of the Lord so cometh as a thief in the night. Hey, the scriptures say our salvation is nearer than when we believe, man. Okay? Our salvation is nearer than when we believe. Hey, it can go down this year. We can get out of here this year, man. All right? Because we hastening. It's the year of hastening, the day of the coming of Yahweh Bashimau Shah, our Lord, man. All right, verse 3, the point it says, for when they shall say peace and safety, things are opening back up. People got their two doses of the juice. You know, they think they good, man. They think they can go back to normal. You know, these sports venues are trying to open up. They open up a more high percentage capacity rate. You know, they think it's all good, man. All right, it says again, for when they shall say peace and safety, then sudden destruction cometh upon them as travail upon a woman with child, and they shall not escape. And y'all not going to escape the judgments of Yahweh Bashimau Shah, man. Because a judgment is laid out for the wicked, okay? Like the scriptures say, the famine, the death, destruction, sword, just roughly paraphrase, I'm not saying verbatim. All these were created for the wicked, man. So if we stay in the faith and we part of the Lord's elect, you know, we endure, we don't have none of this to worry about, man. Okay, we don't have none of this to worry about. All right. So, hey, man, a time of trouble is coming, man. Many great miseries, man. All right. Hey, the scriptures say perilous times shall come when you read 2 Timothy 3:1. Okay. In the last days, perilous times shall come, man. All right, so hey, that's all I wanted to touch on, man. Hey, Lord willing, this was edifying. I want to start off by giving all praise. I want to end off by giving all praises again to Yahweh Bahasham, Yahweh Shai Bahasham Rakakwadash, the Master of the Apostles and Elders at Great Millstone Well. Peace, love, and salutations to the hopeful elect throughout the four corners of earth, preaching this word in the truth and in sincerity. So again, Shalom, Kwame Ashala, and Ababa Ball. Shalom.